choices, whether you are a mama, want to be a mama, you're a grandmama, or an auntie, this is a great resource to have. The cool thing about using oils in babies is like you can use them on yourself too. So there's really so many practical ways to use oils from this class. So I'm Casey Capra, hosting this with a couple of other lovely ladies that you'll hear from later this evening. I love this class because my son was really the reason I got into oils. I had my first child and was like, whoa, I can't trust any of these products. You know, they have all these toxic ingredients. I don't really know where to start. And I was really overwhelmed until I found Young Living. Their oils are such, like, they're the highest standard for oils. Their standards for purity are out of this world. And they also have a ton of just the baby products and the easy swaps and the easy cleaners, because as a new mom, I didn't want to DIY a bunch of stuff and reinvent the wheel. I just wanted a company I could trust that I knew was for me and for my kids, and really found that in Young Living and totally fell in love with it. So love talking about this specifically with Young Living and helping other mamas and women feel equipped and confident with using oils and these other products. So can you guys hear me okay? I'm outside and I just realized the wind is kind of blowing a little bit. So if it gets weird, just let me know. So, okay. Again, welcome. We're going to be talking about a lot of things tonight. So you'll hear us talk about oils and talk about the Young Living products. Most of the oils we talk about are going to come from the premium starter kit, because that's the best place to start. That's where almost everybody starts. And it's like what I like to call the new mama's tool belt. Like, seriously, I use my starter kit all the time. So it's not just like the place to start. It's like the place you hang out. Like, it's like your first aid kit. It's like what you do when you're having a bad day. It's where you go when you're sore. It's where you go when you're emotional, all of the things. So we talk about the starter kit a lot, because not only where you begin, it's like where you continue. It's like the launching pad for all the things. Okay. So well, we will try and make a note of all of the things that are in the starter kit as we talk about them, and give you all these resources. So also, before I forget, put your email in the chat box, because we have a really cool printout full of recipes. All the recipes we're going to talk about tonight are in this PDF that we're going to email to you after the class. So make sure you put your email in the chat. And if anybody pops in late, make sure to remind them, since I can't quite see when people are popping on. So, okay. So, first things first, safety first. The trickiest part, I would say, probably the only tricky part about using oils with kids is being confident in how to use them safely. Essential oils are incredibly potent. Young Living essential oils are super pure, super concentrated. They're 100% what they say they are, which means they pack a big punch. You do not need to use a lot. Especially with kids, you need to use even a smaller amount. So, always dilute when starting out with kiddos. I like to recommend that you also test out your carrier oil. So, a lot of times when we say dilute your oils, we're talking about using a fatty oil with your essential oil, because essential oils are very small and volatile. They evaporate very quickly. A fatty oil like coconut oil or grapeseed oil helps them be a little gentler on baby skin, helps them evaporate a little bit slower, and it's super helpful. Also stretches your oils a little farther. But I will say, especially with babies, also test your carrier oil. My son was sensitive to coconut oil, so I got a little freaked out for a little bit with that, because I was like, I'm just using lavender and coconut oil. What's the big deal? Like, why is he having a reaction? And it was the coconut oil. So we use grapeseed oil in our house. So, always use them in a small area, like something on like their ankle or something that is gonna be non-irritating, to kind of test it out and make sure it's a good fit for their skin type. So always dilute with kiddos. And really, it's a lot of common sense. So if they have a chest issue, you can put oils on their chest. If they have a tummy issue, put it on their tummy. Or if they're tugging at their ears, put it around their ears. You don't put oils in your ears or in your eyes, but you can put them around your ears. And the bottom of the feet is like, when in doubt, put it on their feet and stick some socks on them, because then they can't mess with it. And the bottom of your feet have thousands of nerve endings connected to every part of your body system. So when you put it on the bottom of their feet, it's getting to their stomach, it's getting to their brain, it's getting to their the part of their brain that helps them go to sleep. It's getting to their immune systems. And that's a really great catch-all place to put it. So let me make sure I'm not skipping anything. So a lot of times, if you're not familiar with how to use oils, you see us using those rollers a lot. When it comes to potent essential oils, like stronger ones, like Digize, that comes in the kit. That's a really great one for gassy tummies. You'll hear us talk about that later. But you only put one drop, and then you fill the rest up with carrier oil. That's all you need. And the great part about it is you can use it on yourself too, because it doesn't water it down. It just makes it more gentler on your skin. So one other little safety tip is for little babies, peppermint and eucalyptus can be a little bit strong on their lungs. So we will talk about other oils to use instead if you want to support their lungs. Talk about this a little bit later, but typically I would avoid diffusing or wearing peppermint and eucalyptus or blends with those oils for little tiny humans, or diffusing them in a closed space. So that brings me to the next note of diffusing. Can you diffuse around little kids? Yes, you should diffuse around little kids. This is a great way to boost their immune systems. You know, a lot of times, especially if you have lots of littles, your hands are full, you're a little bit overwhelmed, you can't find the rollers, you can't find, you know, you're scrambling all over the place. Put some thieves in the diffuser, just let it run all day, and you're cleansing the air in the room, you are boosting their immune systems, you are loving on their bodies and supporting their bodies without having to do the whole, I need two hands to rub this on your body type of thing. So, definitely diffuse. Like I said, if you're a little bit nervous about super littles and thieves or eucalyptus, just diffuse in a very big open space. But diffusing gentle oils like lavender and gentle baby and frankincense are amazing to just be diffusing all the time for your sanity, for the baby's health, for the baby's sleep, all of the things. So I am going to pass this on to our next host. I don't remember who is next, sorry. And we are going to talk all about pregnancy and pregnant oils, which is something I just am finishing up my first oily pregnancy. So this has been really fun. I'm due on Tuesday. So really excited. I'm not sure who is talking about this next, but you have the floor.
It's me. Hi, I'm Shauna. I have been using oils for, I think, 3 years now, three, I think. And I have had an oily pregnancy. My last daughter is 16 months. I guess it would have to be 3 years that I've been using, because that was well before she was conceived. So I've had an oily pregnancy and an oily baby now. I have, between my husband and I, we have 7 other kids, so lots of kids in the house. And we've been using oils around them. So I'm super excited to be here tonight and talk to everybody. We're gonna start with where it began, which is the pregnancy. And there are so many good oils for during the pregnancy. There are a couple to stay away from in the earlier trimesters, but for the most part, most are safe. All the common oils for anxiety, hypnobirthing, and all other emotional support you need during the pregnancy. A bunch that are in the starter kit, like frankincense, peace and calming, valor, lavender, all great oils for anxiety and other emotional support that you might have. There's also, I think Casey hit on it a little bit, for the heartburn. Digize is a good one to use. I actually use Digize and peppermint in a roller bottle, and I kept that one with me, especially during the first trimester, and it helped so much with those ailments early on in the pregnancy. But Digize is, both of those are in the starter kit, and I can't speak highly enough about them. Alkaline supplement is another good one. It's one of the actual supplements that Young Living has. Sorry, I was just nursing. at Marshall. Sorry. But the alkaline supplement naturally balances the stomach's pH, helps kickstart heartburn, or helps kick heartburn. Another amazing one. And with that is one that I took the entire time of my pregnancy and before and after even. It's the Ninja Red. The Ninja Red is packed full of powerful antioxidants to boost your immune system. That one not only boosts your immune system, but it helps with my energy levels, everything. Like Ninja Red is another one that I don't live without. I know a lot of people order it monthly. We order it in bulk. And ever since we started taking it, we have not run out of it in this house. So I've heard people running out of it, and it's not been real good. So we don't run out of Ninja Red. Another great one, I didn't take it during the pregnancy, but I just started taking it, and I really like it, is the Super B. It's good for all the ligaments, all the moving that you do. It contains the natural folate, so your prenatal vitamins contain artificial folic acid, and the Super B contains that natural folate, so it's just a more natural supplement that you can be putting in your body.
Ooh.
And then Young Living also has Omega Jive, which is an amazing fish oil supplement. And that was not just for your moms, but for your dads also. But it helps a lot with that brain, the mama brain fog, whether it's the pregnancy. We all know it does not go away after pregnancy, because then it just turns to mama brain. And then for like face serums and stretch marks and stuff like that, another one that I love using, and these will be in the handout that I email out after this, is myrrh and lavender. And you're gonna wanna hang on to myrrh for later on when the baby's born, but myrrh and lavender on a DIY face serum just helps with everything skin. Frankincense is another one that we love to add to our face serums and for everything skin. And then ladies, it's also good for that perineum massage that you're gonna want prior to birth. It will help prevent tearing during the birth. So for people that have, especially this time of year where it's heating up and people that have circulation issues, there's a roller or a sugar scrub with lemongrass and grapefruit. Lemongrass is a great one to encourage the blood circulation and keep you less puffy. I'm not sure if Casey's doing that one this time, but that one, I know I had an issue at the end of my pregnancy with that, and the lemongrass especially is wonderful for that. If y'all have any questions while we're going along, feel free to type them in the comment section. We have others that are on that can help answer questions or get us to address those when we take a small break for questions. So that's a lot. I know that was a lot of information, but that's a lot on pregnancy. So from the pregnancy, we're going to move on to the baby. So once your baby is here, you're going to ask yourself, where do you start? Which oils do we want? And the first one that I used with this one was myrrh and frankincense. Don't put it right on the umbilical cord, but put it right around, and that's going to help treat that area and keep it from being less irritated and just keep it clean. You can use one or the other. I use both. If you have any knowledge of the Bible, they use both on baby Jesus, and if they're going to use them on him, then I'm going to use it on my baby. So I use both, but you can use either. Frankincense comes in your kit. Myrrh does not. It's an extra one. So worst case scenario, you can use frankincense by itself. It will be just as good, or you can get that one and have both of them. The next thing, the next two that I really like and that are both the frankincense and lavender are really, really good combinations. Just very calming. They're good to diffuse. And then lemon and purification are also really good ones. And we're going to talk about, in the packet that you get, we'll have some recipes. I'm going to tell you some of them, but those are ones that we're going to use for some of our recipes. So frankincense and lavender and lemon and purification. So for happy ears, and sorry, I have the packet right here, so I'm going to have to look at it. But I don't, none of us really remember all of the recipes. That's why we have resources. So for the happy ears, if you make a roller, and you're going to have 4 drops of purification and 4 of lemon, and then you're going to top it with a carrier oil of your choice. And then you just rub that around the ears and behind the ears. Remember, don't ever put an oil inside the ear. You just go around the ears and behind the ears and then down the back of the neck. And that will, anytime your baby is pulling at their ears, batting at the ears, or have a even just congestion where you think ear infections are coming, a lot of times with teething, you'll have some unhappy ears. So that's just a good one to have on hand is happy ears. The other one is happy breathing. Let's see if I can do this with a nursing baby. Everybody can do it. We're in it together. So the happy breathing oils are myrtle, lemon, purification, and frankincense and copaiba. And so those are good ones to put in the diffuser anytime that you want to support their breathing, or anytime they are starting to dip below the wellness line. They're fairly mild, but they're really effective. For us adults, where we might use the eucalyptus and peppermint, for the babies, we want to use more of the myrtle, lemon, purification, frankincense, and copaiba. And then for a natural, to neutralize odors, because we know those diapers can get pretty rank, especially as they get older. There is, let me find what page that's on. Purification is always a good one when you want to purify the air. And then thieves always is a good one to cleanse the air to get rid of things that we don't want our baby breathing in. I believe that's all for mine. Thanks, Suzanne. Are you up next?
No, it's Kirsten. Kirsten.
Yeah, I thought okay. Kirsten was before me. There yeah. We go.
I'm sorry.
No, that's okay. So I'm just going to add a few things that I use during pregnancy that haven't been mentioned yet, at least one of them. So as one of the great things that is about oils that you can try different things that you feel comfortable. It's all about choice and what you like and your comfort level with things. So I know peppermint and digize was mentioned for heartburn. Peppermint wasn't one that I wanted to use, but again, you have that power of choice when you have these in your home. You get to choose what you want to use. So for me, what really worked great for me was my heartburn was orange. I put orange right on it and it took it right away. And I actually didn't think that that would be something that would work, but it worked great and the heartburn stopped. Another thing for me was for my belly, just to kind of try and keep stretch marks from coming. And it actually did a pretty good job, I'm going to say. And that, and probably drinking lots of water. I'm going to recommend that because I don't want to just say it's just that. But coconut oil and lavender, I would put that on my hands and I would just rub it on my belly. And I love that. And it was just a nice connection moment too, just to have with my belly, which I really loved. For labor, I actually took them. I was actually planning on having a home birth. So I had Envision with me, all set up to have here. That plan did not work out. So I was a little bit anxious on the way to the hospital. This is my second baby. And so I had Peace and Calming 2 with me and Valor. And I think I had Lavender as well. So for me, I diffused Peace and Calming 2 the whole time I was in labor at the hospital, just because it's not what I planned. And whenever something doesn't go as planned, maybe not for you, but for me, that makes me anxious. I like thinking that I have control over things. So I used that. And afterwards, our baby was born and he had some slight infection in his blood. So again, not knowing what was going on, it just made me nervous. So I continued diffusing Peace and Calming too. I had Lavender. I was smelling that. I would sit there in the chair and just smell it, because I actually did end up having some sort of panic attack in the hospital because I was just a bundle of nerves and I was anxious and I wasn't sure what's going on. So Lavender and Peace and Calming too were like, I needed those. As soon as I started smelling them, and even now if I find myself getting a little bit worked up, Valor, Peace and Calming 2, Lavender are my go-tos to bring those emotions down for me. So I'm going to get back over to what we were talking about before, though. Some other great oils for baby that I have used. Actually, Gentle Baby has become a new favorite in this house. It is lavender, ylang-ylang, Roman chamomile, palmarosa, geranium, and coriander. So I use this one on my little one with sleepy eyes is what it's called. It's in the Kid Sense line. So I use those two together, and I'll actually take the two oils and I will put a drop on my thumbs and I will rub it on his lovey. So it's not actually going onto his skin. I will diffuse it in his room too, but that way it's a little bit closer. I do roll it on the bottom of his feet, but I really would like him to sleep. So the more places I can get it and for him to smell it, I try to put it. So that is one that we've been using. So other great things, lavender and frankincense with this and Gentle Baby is good for stretch marks. I think there's a body butter recipe. I think that's in the sheet that's coming. You can put it in the diffuser for sleep time, as I mentioned, in the baths for moms, and again, calming for baby. I use that on mine. He is much different than my first. He is a little bit fussier, so oils have become an even bigger friend of mine. I do want to mention, because I saw lavender on here for, did we do postpartum yet? I don't know if we're going to do that. But one thing I used for postpartum care, actually, and lavender comes in the premium starter kit. So I would actually, for recovery, and I think this would probably depend on your birth experience, but for me, I didn't have a lot of tearing. So I would actually put a drop of lavender right in that lining of my underwear, and it helped heal all the things that are going on down there. So I did that for both pregnancies, and it really helped me. Another oil that we're going to talk about is for happy bellies, which again, I've used this on my little one who's had some tummy troubles at times. We've all done those bicycle legs and it's just not getting things moving maybe as much as we'd like, or we want that belly to feel better. So a couple oils for that with diluting. You have Roman chamomile, Gentle Baby again, lemon, which comes in the kit, tummy jives, and digize, which comes in the kit if you don't have tummy jives. I didn't have tummy jives, so I use one drop in a carrier or a roller bottle with carrier oil, and I would roll it, kind of make an in lowercase in shape over the belly button. And I did notice that it would help him not be so fussy with those gas pains. So again, bottoms of the feet, that's another great one. I've done that, putting it on my hand, rubbing his feet, because even I've used Gentle Baby like that, rubbing his feet, because sometimes you're just, you've tried all the things and you don't know maybe what it is, but just massaging them and trying to get them to calm down. And they have so many different points on the bottom of their feet that it can absorb and get to where it needs to get to for them, for what they're needing, which I think that's one of the greatest things about oils, because they're not able to communicate fully what they're needing all the time. They don't have those communication skills. So when you're able to, okay, I know this oil can be great for lots of things like lavender. Let me just put some lavender diluted on the bottom of the feet because it has all the points and the body can do what it needs to do to help. Breastfeeding mamas, if you're consuming caffeine, chocolate, dairy, tomatoes, protein shakes, or a good amount of leafy greens, those can cause a little bit of extra gas. So it might require experimenting with your diet too. Another thing that's mentioned, that if baby might have had a traumatic birth or had needed some interventions, and can throw off antibiotics, can throw off your gut flora too. And so to rebuild the flora, you can open a capsule of Life 9 and sprinkle it on the breast or add a half capsule to their bottle or milk. I noticed for me too, like just drinking that Ninjex Red can also help with like just in your milk, because they're getting all those nutrients too when you're breastfeeding. But those are some great tips. For colic, they said to encourage to give your baby tummy time, rubbing the foot again with any of those oils. And there's a video you can YouTube, The 5 S's by Dr. Harvey Karp, that can go along with that. So yeah, those are some great things and I would definitely recommend them. I'm not sure if it for, do we talk about breastfeeding support? I'm not sure if we mentioned that at all. But for me, I used fennel. Fennel helped increase milk supply. A couple of times when I noticed my milk supply was going down a little bit, I would just nurse on that side. I would, then when he was done nursing, I would apply the fennel and make sure I was drinking lots of water. So you'll see I have my water here to make sure that milk supply stays up. And for me, this is an easy way, because if I drink 4 of these, I've drank a gallon a day. And that's the goal that my midwife gave me to get to maintain my supply. So fennel was a great one to just rub on there after they've nursed. You can rub it on there. I also did copiaba for nursing, because sometimes they like to bite when they want to comfort. So that was another good one for me. Or even when you're first starting and you haven't got that latch quite right, copiaba with coconut oil right on that area, maybe not actually on the nipple, but the areola area is fine. And if you need to, you could just wipe it off with a damp cloth before nursing baby. But that would help that area feel better. So those are some tricks that I have found along the way, and I hope it blesses you.
All right, I think it's me now. So I'm Suzanne, and I, everybody hear me good? Am I good? Okay. I did not have oily pregnancies. I did not start using oils until after my second pregnancy. Not too long after, because they were little. My second pregnancy was actually twins. So they are 5 now, but I started using oils when they were little. So I like I said, I didn't really do the pregnancy thing, but I've used a lot of stuff on little ones. And a lot of stuff that I used even when they were little tiny, I'm still using on them now, and they just turned 5. So one of the things I'm going to talk about is immunity, and which obviously is kind of a hot button thing right now. Everybody wants to keep their immune system up. So we want to keep those little ones' immune systems up. And I know for me, my son was in kindergarten when my daughters were born, and he wanted to bring them in for show and tell. So I took my little 6-week-old babies into a nasty germy school for show and tell because he was so excited. But I did a lot of, I would make like a roller bottle with thieves, very little bit of thieves, I used a lot of coconut oil on mine, but whatever fatty oil you like, and I would put it on their feet. Because I know a couple other people have mentioned how great it is for putting everything on their feet, and it is. But when they're that was when they were probably a little bit older. But when they're little tiny, diffusing these is a really good one. And if you kind of notice they're kind of you're afraid they might be getting sick, you can take like one drop of lavender or frankincense or purification, which are all great oils, and you want to use like one drop. I know I would do it like in the palm of my hand. I would put one drop of the oil, and then like I had like a pump coconut oil, and I would do like a pump because you want to mix it pretty good with a carrier oil. And then I just rub it down on them. I mean, I just kind of slap it on there, and I would rub their bellies, their backs, their feet, you know, just when you're, a lot of times I'd be getting them out of the bath or changing them into their jammies or whatever, and just kind of rub it all over them and then get them in their jammies. Because you want to make sure they don't get on their hands, because you don't want them to get it in their mouths or in their eyes or anything like that. So a lot of times I would do that before I put them in their jammies, because then they're all covered up. They're not going to get it on their hands. So one of the other things, and like I said, you can use any of those three oils. You can do one, you could rotate, kind of do whatever you wanted. Teething is another big one. Copa Iba, several people have talked about that oil already for other stuff, and it's actually one of my favorites. I love it. I love that oil. I use it for lots and lots of stuff, and it's very, very mild. Some of the oils are going to feel warmer. It won't burn you, but it'll feel really warm on your skin, like a peppermint or a thieves or something like that. But Copa Iba is not. It's super mild. And so you can actually take it directly and stick it on their teeth if they're teething or on their gums. And you can actually use it as a grown-up in your mouth too, which is my dad is in his 60s and he was having tooth pain, and they were at my house and I was like, come here. And I like slapped some in his mouth and he was like, wow, I feel better. So I know that if a grown-up feels better, a little one must feel a lot better. So that's another one you can also put on their chest if they're having some, I don't want to say lung issues, but you know, I mean, they need to breathe a little easier or anything like that. You can dilute a little Copa Iba and rub that on their chest, and that'll help kind of open up everything. So one of the other things that I want to talk about is the seedlings line, which it has several different products in it. And this is some of my favorite things. Like I said, my daughters are 5. I still use the seedlings lotion on them because I love it. I love it so much. I still use the shampoo. I still use the lotion. I mean, I love it. It's fantastic. But that whole line does not have any alcohol, chlorine, mineral oil, anything animal derived, sulfates, lanolin, parabens, phthalates, petrochemicals, anything synthetic, fragrances, dyes, none of that, which, you know, as a mom with little ones, you're afraid of all that stuff. You hear about it, how all of it's terrifying, how, you know, it can do all of these negative things, and you know, that's all super scary. So it's fabulous to have a line that you can go to that you know is great for them. And so they have a diaper rash cream, There's a baby oil. There's a linen spray, which is fabulous for spraying in their crib, spraying on their lovey or their stuffed animal or their blankie or whatever it is they sleep with. Obviously, because mine are a little older, they sleep with like 18 stuffed animals. So I still spray it. And I still diffuse gentle baby and lavender in their room. It's amazing for helping them calm down. Gentle baby was like amazing when mine were little. I discovered that very early on in my oily journey, I guess. And I would put it in roller. I would do lavender and gentle baby in like a roller bottle and then fill it with whatever carrier oil and rub it on them, their feet, their chests. Sometimes I would just rub it across their crib mattress, you know, on their sheet, whatever it took. Because like Kirsten said, I wanted those babies to sleep. I had twins, they need to sleep. Mama was tired. So that was another fabulous one that I did. Another thing I do with lavender as they got a little older and they started kind of sitting up in the bath and stuff, I would do some Epsom salts and a little bit of lavender, especially at bedtime, because you know, if you go in there, you shut the bathroom door and the steam is making the lavender smell really amazing and you're almost asleep on the bathroom floor, and it really helps them calm down and go to sleep. And, you know, we had our whole routine, you know, between that and rubbing that lotion on them and diffusing, they're like out like a light. So anyway, so the seedling line is fabulous. If you haven't seen it, check it out. It's really amazing. And those are kind of all of the tips that I think that I have. Yep, I think so. So I think Casey is next.
Yes, this is so good. You guys, I'm learning so much. I love all of these things. So gentle baby is one of my favorites too, just for like myself. And now like the seedlings calm oil is just incredible. And I think one thing we haven't touched on yet is like why to use sleepy oils with kiddos or adults even. But especially with kiddos, like as a mom, we can strategically incorporate oils so well, because when you smell something, it goes to the area of your brain that goes to memories and emotions. So when you can attach the smell of lavender or gentle baby or peace and calming, whatever blend you love or your kid loves, when you can attach the memory and emotion of sleepiness with that oil, it is a game changer, because you don't have to tell them, hey, it's time to go to bed. You can just start diffusing stuff, or you can just spray down their blankets, or you can be traveling and make a hotel room smell like home, and they'll sleep so much better because you have built that sleep association. Same thing with just building a calm oil blend for them. I know sometimes it's frustrating, like if your kid's having a tantrum and you slather some lavender on them, that might not be as effective as if you had been using lavender during calm moments already. They need to have that calm memory association built already. So like I have a friend, lavender gives her like an anxiety attack because her mom was always diffusing lavender only when she had an anxiety attack. And so that is the memory associated with it. Whereas if you are using peace and calming during your bedtime routine every night, and they're having memories of you snuggling and reading books with them, like that is the association you're building. So just a quick note on that, because I realized we didn't talk about that earlier. So okay, so last kind of stage we're going to talk about is postpartum, okay? Because after you have a kiddo, it is not only important that you know how to support their bodies, but you need to support your body. Because if mama ain't happy, ain't nobody happy. But if also mama ain't healthy, it's going to be really draining on you to help everybody else get healthy or stay healthy. So when we're pregnant, our progesterone levels are just like to the moon. At least with a healthy pregnancy, like progesterone is what keeps you pregnant. So it is just way up here. As soon as you have that baby, your body says, great, we don't need you anymore. And it's down it goes.
and it's like it takes a break. Progesterone takes a vacay, and your body's kind of left in a little bit of a shock. So this is where you'll feel some women have intense moodiness or really low feelings that are just not like them. It can get really dangerous, or it could just be like, I don't quite feel like myself. Like, it's just this iffiness. So taking care of your progesterone levels is really going to come in clutch, especially postpartum, like directly after postpartum. So I'm so thankful for Progestins Plus that Young Living has this product. It's a wild yam extract and oil blend that naturally supports your progesterone levels. It is not artificial progesterone. Really, all it does is when you put it on your body, it says, hey, knock, knock, time to like boost some progesterone. Come on, we can do this. It has progesterone mimicking effects that remind your body, this is still an important hormone. You need to keep producing this. And it really helps balance out that hormonal roller coaster. So I noticed a gigantic difference postpartum. I didn't even start using this until 6 months postpartum. And I was noticing the first 2 weeks of my cycle, I was fine. But those last 2 weeks of my cycle, when progesterone is supposed to be carrying me through, I was just not myself. And so I was rolling it on myself every morning and every evening consistently. And it really, really supported my body beautifully. So EndoFlex is another favorite, helps balance the endocrine system where the thyroid lives. Okay, so your endocrine system is what is helping all your hormones talk to each other. You need to love your endocrine system well. So we use EndoFlex every day. I put it on me and my toddler every day because toddlers have hormones and big emotions that need to be taken care of. So do middle schoolers, so do high schoolers, so do husbands, but we're working on that one. So you can do, you can put it over your thyroid, right on your neck. I personally prefer it over my adrenals because I don't love the smell of the spearmint. It's a pretty strong smell to me for some reason. Maybe it's just because I'm pregnant. I don't know. And it just really loves on your endocrine system and helps it get moving and be like, okay, don't forget, don't let me down today. So that one's actually a freebie this month, which is cool. Postpartum down there, in your packet that you're getting in your email, there's a Hootie Healing Spray. I love that name. That is helpful for postpartum healing. And there's also the Clariderm Spray if you don't want to DIY it. And I think, did one of y'all say y'all use Lavaderm? So there's Clariderm and Lavaderm. Both are great. If you have a C-section, frankincense and lavender, which are in the kit, are amazing for your skin. Lavender actually helps regenerate your skin cells. So that is a really powerful oil to be putting on all areas of your skin. If you need some rectal care after the baby is born, lavender and geranium is an amazing support as well. Emotional helpers, y'all, when you have a baby, you just start diffusing all of the emotional support oils. So a lot of them come in the kit, like Valor. This one is a really, really, really amazing one, especially if you're nervous as a new mom, or if you're feeling low, or if you're just feeling like, I can't do this, use Valor. Stress Away is another amazing one. It's like being on the beach with a mojito. It really just helps take the edge off your stress. Citrus oils are really powerful mood boosters. The way they talk to your brain chemistry, they naturally lift your brain chemistry just by inhaling them. So that is a really, really powerful thing that you can utilize. Just park some citrus oils next to your diffuser. Park a bottle of water next to your diffuser so you can just refill it every time you pass it and just have citrus oils going all the time. And then Joy. Joy's the one that does not start come in the starter kit, but it's one of my all-time favorites. I got so hooked on this one after I had my baby. It is just packed full of all of the emotional powerhouse oils. So many floral, beautiful smells. I was postpartum, I was putting it over my heart every day. I had it in a little roller next to my toothbrush so I didn't forget. And I put it over my heart every day. And then I ran out and I realized I was getting really moody. and I was like, oh, that must have been doing something good for me. And so joy is a really, really great one, especially if you are having some really tough emotional times when you were postpartum. Or you can cram them all into one roller, call it the sunshine roller, and that's in your packet too. And you just cram them all in there and just roll them all over yourself all of the time. I like to keep oils like that in my pocket, like literally in my pocket while I'm going throughout my day. So postpartum energy, Super B, we already talked about that one. So stinking good. It is an amazing energy boost. Nature Red, also talked about that. Super Fruit Wolfberry Puree Juice. It is absolutely incredible. It's a great thing to just try for 30 days and then stop and see how you're feeling and see if your energy drop. My energy levels just super dropped. But it's a great thing to support your body when you're breastfeeding or when you're just keeping kids alive. it is really incredible. Milk Supply. Yes, there is a got milk roller recipe. I know Kirsten touched on this a little bit and phenomenal. So glad she talked about that. I'm really excited to have that resource this time around. And rose ointment is also really helpful for nursing care. If you have chapped areas, especially if you have like breastfeeding issues, rose ointment is super healing and super supportive to your skin. So, if you guys have questions, now is a great time to pop them in the chat real fast. Cause I want to make sure we're wrapping up kind of on time. We talked a lot about the starter kit. The premium starter kit is the $165. It comes with a beautiful diffuser for you to diffuse all those citrus oils. Comes with 12 oils. We talked about almost all of them. we didn't even talk about like Pan Away, which is amazing for your muscles. Y'all, when I was up in the middle of the night breastfeeding a baby and my mattress was 11 years old, my body was not a fan of me. Pan Away was a lifesaver. We have like Thieves for your immune system and peppermint. That one's a little iffy to use while you're nursing. And sometimes people don't feel comfortable with while they're pregnant, but for, weaning, it is amazing. For after your kids are grown, it is amazing. All of the things. Frankincense is incredibly emotionally supportive for postpartum moms. But anyways, like I said before in the beginning of this class, we all are obsessed with the starter kit. It's where we start. It's where we stay. So we could talk about it all night long. But if that is something where you're like, girl, I need that resource, message the person who invited you to this class because they obviously love their starter kit and want you to feel confident and equipped and like so set in your motherhood journey and want you to be equipped with these tools. So message them and be like, girl, help me get one. Okay. And does anybody have, I saw that y'all mentioned the Gentle Babies book and the Betsy Bosom book. Those are really, great resources. So just making sure there are any questions. Are you guys good? Yes. Gentle Babies. Girl, that book is everything. That book is everything. She goes really in depth into like how to like gently introduce oils to your baby. She even says, really loved this because I was really nervous to put oils on Jonah when he was little, to just put oils on your hand and let them and just kind of wave them over their face so they can inhale it off your hand. If you really, I know some moms don't feel comfortable putting oils on their kids right away, and that is totally okay. You are the mom. You follow your mom gut. That is why they are your kid, because that is for you to decide. But just like letting them inhale it a little bit on your hand is still powerful. It's getting into their system. It's feeding their bodies. But I love that she had that tip because I was like, oh, that's a great first step for me while I'm still feeling nervous about this. So, does anybody else have any other last minute things? If not, I'm going to close this out.
Oh, I was going to say something really cute, really quick, if that's okay.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
You said about putting it on your hands. For me, when I was snuggling my little one or nursing him, I would put it right here on my forearm so that way when he was snuggled in, he could smell it and it would be close enough or even a little bit further up. So, but it wasn't on him until I felt comfortable. But that way we were both getting the benefit because I could smell it, he could smell it, and we were, and like you were saying, it provided a good association too, because now he has that mommy snuggling me and that smell there together. Another thing, we're talking about the seedlings line, and I love that line. One of the things that I love is the wipes, and I use those for in between bath days. So if the boys, it's not bath day because we don't bathe every day. I'm just going to be honest and tell you that. They don't bathe every day, and they don't need to bathe every day. So, and when they're babies, they really don't need to bathe every day. So I would just use a wipe, and I would wipe him down if he got a lot of spit up on him, because sometimes the neck gets a little rank from the milk sitting there, so you got to wipe it out. So I would use the wipe, and I felt comfortable doing that, and it was gentle, and it smelled really good. So I use that for my boys. And if you got tired mama eyes, the diaper rash cream, right under here. Before, and then you put your makeup over it and it looks great, okay? So it's 2-for-1. Maybe get your own bottle though, because, areas probably shouldn't mix. But that is my other tip. So I always love when I can use something in more than one way. So I don't know if anyone else has any tips, but those were some I thought of.
I have two tips on the wipe. So I use cloth diapers, and a lot of times when you're wiping that poopy diaper, the wipes end up in the diaper and then end up in the wash. They don't shred, they stay, and it is no issues. I can't tell you how many wipes have gone through my washer, and it's not an issue for them to go in. You're not going to see like toilet paper, like shredded stuff in your wash or anything like that. They're whole. So they're very durable and great to use. I use them on everything.
Awesome. Yeah, those are really good tips. That is so good. Well, thank you, ladies, so much for hosting this with me. I really enjoyed this. This was so fun. Don't forget to drop your email so we can send you guys that printable. And if nobody has any other questions or anything they'd like to hop on and share, I think we're going to close this out.
Hey, Casey.
Just have a great night.
Casey, just so for everybody that's not familiar, if you're not on your phone, I don't think you can do it on your phone, but on the computer, there's three dots at the bottom of the chat. You can go in and save this chat. So if there were any recipes that you wanted, you're going to get the PDF, but if there's anything else that you want, make sure before we close this call out, you save that chat.
Yes. All right, ladies. Well, thanks again, and I hope you guys have a great night. You guys know where to find us if you have questions.